old.
Let's bring it back home to Louisiana. We have our own U.S. senator who's admitted to serious sins. He's been linked to a prostitution ring in Louisiana and in D.C., who seriously has been harmed by this whole scandal. I believe the state has been harmed. Should Louisiana residents, Bruce, be calling for his resignation? Should he follow Eliot Spitzer's moral lead and resign?
The practical difference is, it may not be a legal difference, the practical difference in the two is Vitter apparently came clean with his family before, you know, the rest of us were really aware of it. Quite a different story, it appears, with Spitzer, and it happened a number of years ago. So within the family, perhaps there's been healing, there's been divulging of information, and the family's still intact. Different deal. From a legal perspective, the laws were broken.
How about from a spiritual perspective, a biblical perspective, what's the difference?
Well, there is no difference from a biblical perspective.
All right.
Well, the question was,
my case.
But the question was, his being in office. I mean, Scripture doesn't tell us
should he resign
Vitter from office.
Let's see.
I think if we're going to be consistent, then we should
ask for his resignation
to resign.
Okay, but he's not going to. So that's the situation.
Let's go back to Scripture again. What Scripture does say about public office? For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to evil. Do not be afraid of power. Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he, the public official, is a minister of God for good. Okay, so now we've established that public officials are ministers of God. Maybe not on the level of a pastor, but still a minister. So now the yardstick is raised.
Yeah.
Too much is given, much is expected. If Joe Blow goes out there and has an affair or gets a prostitute, that's one thing. But if a minister...
Right.
So you would you suggest that the pastor of a church commits adultery, that he should just stay there and no one should call for it? Or should he step down, be restored, and then come back?
No, I'm on the same page with you.
I'm
simply saying, you know, the question was about the office. And I've known ministers that have been in that situation. And I would counsel them to get out of the pulpit as well.
So absolutely.
We're all in agreement here, but we're all looking at a situation that probably will not occur because I think he's going to hang on to his position. And then the people have to decide if they want to make it an issue and raise the temperature for him to do so.